Oh, I'm running out of ammo on my 9. Oh! He flipped me off! Oh, that was cool! He flipped me off!
In a world searching for gaming knowledge comes the man, the myth, a legend in his own mind, Critical.
Welcome back, guys and gals. Critical here, and today I'm bringing you another episode of Subsistence. All right, before I started this episode, I was getting ready to go out and do some farming, and two hunters decided to attack me, but I wasn't ready to record, and when I hit my recording software, my frames were all messed up. Now, I did have the footage, but it was so choppy, I couldn't use it, so I had to go ahead and delete it. But two hunters attacked, I defended my base, took both hunters out, and I talk about it after I start this episode, but I never really gave you an intro. So guess what? You just had an intro. Let's get to the video. Enjoy. All right, now we're back and my frames are locked back at 60. Every time I hook my laptop to its docking station when I get back from work, the settings get kind of wonky sometimes. And like I said, I was actually going to go out and do some grinding for wood and stuff. That was the main focus of me logging in today. And I got hit. I always have my recording software running in the background just in case, but because I wasn't planning on starting an episode, I wasn't ready to start recording. So I apologize for the nastiness of the frames, but you know, sometimes that happens. Ooh, I see cloth. Not even food, I see cloth. Come here. Oh, got him on the move. When they're walking away from it, coming toward me, I can usually get them. So when they're moving left or right, that's when I'm gonna have a problem. So my plan really was, is that inside or outside the fence? Oh, you little, ooh, that's mean. That's mean. All right, two over here to make up for that one. But I need fruits and vegetables again. Now, those hunters attacked me during the day, so their house should be open? I can at least go check their fire. I'm not going to waste my time breaking into their place. I did that last episode, and God, what a waste of my time. I would have been better served just to run around and pick up crates and stuff like that. Now, there shouldn't be anything over here, except for a stupid wolf. Level 3. I'm going to leave him alone. I'm just going to grab this crate, go around him, and check their fire and see if there's anything worthwhile in their fire. Where are you going, Mr. Wolf? Okay. Now, I wish these guys were here. If they hadn't attacked me, they would have had a battle with that wolf. And I would love to catch that on screen. I haven't been able to show my viewers that. Now, please, go watch Game Edge and Bloodstalker. I believe they've both had... I know Game Edge for sure... And I think Bloodstalker has caught them fighting animals on screen as well. So go check that out. It's actually pretty cool when that happens. I got a wolf and a bear. I think I can make it in between them pretty good. Oh, there's another crate. Nope. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. You never saw that crate. Erase that crate from your mind. It doesn't exist. I wish I had made it over here, because this is really where I wanted to build, but oh well. I'm still learning the map. I'm considered a newbie to this game, I'll admit it. Yes, I'm doing videos on it because I love it so much, but I'm definitely a noob when it comes to this game. But yeah, go check out Bloodstalker and Game Edge. They've been able to capture interactions between hunters and animals, which I haven't been able to do yet. I haven't even heard them popping off shots at him yet. Okay. I think I'm good. I'll grab this.
on the run. I'm good. Ooh, and scrap metal. You will be seeing a log lapse today. That's a definite. I am woefully low on wood. But I'll turn this into an impromptu episode. Yes. Oh, I'm out of stam. Stupid fruits and vegetables are killing me. I've got one blueberry, I need to save it. I'm gonna keep pumping my protein as high as possible and hoping it gives me enough fruits and vegetables. It gives me a minuscule amount of vegetables when I eat protein, but maybe it'll be enough to keep me going. Because I believe in what Game Edge says, that the best way to move around in this game is to run. As long as you keep your ears on, you should be all right. I just have to keep a better watch on it because my fruits and vegetables are so low. But I need to find water, or go ahead and build a wellhead. But I'd want some more power. Before I put a wellhead down, because that takes a lot of power. I'd like to have a solar panel or two down. But to get the solar panel, I need to make a recycler. Now, I did make a mass fabricator, but I went ahead and dismantled it to get half the resources back because it takes way too much power to run that thing. And the return on the power it's taking versus what it's giving me just isn't enough to make it worth it. So I'm gonna make a recycler instead, but I have to wait until I have 1,000 power. Or excuse me, 500 power and 100 mass. Well, I didn't have 100 mass, so that's why I was gonna run out and do some farming while my mass built up in my house. And a hunter said, nope, whatever plans you have, put those to the side because we're gonna come raid you. Only fair, I attacked them yet last time I replayed. So, I almost said yesterday, but it was definitely, you know, several days ago. Now, I have one of my viewers, Humor and Politics, originally had purchased this game, and then, you know, just, I guess, couldn't get into it, was having issues with it, but he says because of my videos, he decided to pick it back up. And I think that's really cool. And I'm glad that I've helped somebody else find their love of subsistence. Because I definitely love this game. There we go. I saw I was running around with only one bullet in my pipe. You always want your pipe to be full. A fully loaded weapon is always better than an empty one. Okay, I've got a bear over there. Oh, medical plant. This, thank you. This is a nice area. I actually built, before I started recording this game, this is one of the areas that I built at before. Because I wanted to have this rock right by. Oh man, look at that. Oh, tease. Tease. Because I liked having that rock behind my back. Oh. That is a rogue hunter base, I believe. Quit moving, I can't see you. I want to see if you got a shirt on or not. Yep, rogue hunters. If he's just one, there is a fire There's a crate there. This could be really stupid, but I need that crate. Water, fruits, vegetables. Come on. Chicken is just laughing at me. I'm gonna try to get a good angle on him. There's two. I'm running. There's two. Very poor executed. There's a tree. They usually fire three. Where's he at? Ah, okay, there are two. I thought there was three there for a second. I'm just like hiding behind this tree. Don't shoot me! I like the one guy using the bow. Oh, I'm running out of ammo on my 9. Oh! He flipped me off! Oh, that was cool. He flipped me off. That was awesome. I was stupid for running out there like that. But that was awesome, he flipped me off. Okay, I do not know where I am. If I was near my house, I would know which way to go. God, I hope I don't lose everything. That was so cool. He flipped me off. Oh, I finally died. That's my first death. It was long overdue. I've done some really stupid things. Alright, I'm gonna take a beat. I'm just gonna run this way. And hope I'm going the right way. I'm gonna pass up all the crates and anything that I see. Other than things I can pick up directly on the run. Like the scrap metal and stuff like that that I see. I'm not going to go back for anything that I miss. If I can't catch it on the run, it's not worth it to me. Now, I believe Cold Games had tweaked the timers. Black bear. Watch out for that. Is that the... No, that's not the face. Once I get to the right area, I would know. No, that's definitely not... No, I'm definitely in the wrong area. Okay, where's the house? House is behind me. It's over this way. If I go this direction, I should get back to that area. I know that general area pretty good. I just have to get back into it. Oh, and I'm running out of stamina. That's not a good time to run out of stamina. Come on. Did I get anything? I was hoping I picked up some blueberries there. Oh, all these crates. I'm... Nope, not gonna bother those crates. I'm just gonna keep moving. Fence line. Okay. So I'm a little off of my bearing, but if I go this way, I should get there. Because they were behind where that fire was at, was the fence line. I don't know if I'm gonna get my stuff. Now, if I had enough stamina, I actually would catch that chicken, kill it, and eat it real quick. Ooh, wolf. Bear. Oh my. All right, I'm getting closer to that area, I think. I hope I'm going the right way. I think I'm going the right way. Game Edge and Bloodstalker are looking at going, no, you're not going the right way. That's my house. I left my house. I went to the left. I went along the fence line and then came. Okay, it's right over here, I think. Unless I'm completely mistaken, that's the wolf. I'm completely mistaken. I just ran around in a big circle, didn't I? There's a hole in there, isn't there? No, there's not. But that's not the face I expected to see. I'm gonna lose all my stuff, guys. That sucks, I think. Stamina. I'm completely lost. I just have to keep moving and hope I get over there. I don't think I was this far out. Oh god, I'm so lost. I should have just followed that fence line. Please tell me I didn't really piss him off. But I don't have the stamina to make it. I don't know, guys. I messed up. I messed up seriously. There's still a chance I can get there in time. If I'm going the right way now, I think I could get there in time. Stupid bear. I wanted to keep the same trajectory I was going. Grab it. Oh, those aren't, that's fiber. I really need some blueberries. What am I doing? Don't stop for the fiber. Grab it on the run, but that's it. And I just made the clothing. That's messed up too, because the one rogue hunter actually had gear. You know, he had armor on. And I haven't messed with the rogue hunters unless an animal has. I wonder if animals kill rogue hunters. That counts as, you know, the rogue hunter's getting killed, so they start gearing up. Ooh. That puts an interesting wrinkle in the whole, I'm not gonna mess with my hunters, that way they don't get geared up, because I'm not ready for it. Animals are like, dude, I don't care, I wanna eat. I think I've lost all my gear, guys. Ugh. And I ran past all those crates. I'm gonna keep hoping. I'm gonna keep hope alive. Blueberry, right? Nope, fiber. I still can't tell the difference between those. Nope. Bear. If I have an animal start chasing me right now, I'm just done. Wow, this is a nasty little area. Look at all these animals out here. Nasty little area. Alright, that's the hunter base. My hunters. I'm gonna try to cut between these. Oh, please just tell me I got the first warning and not a chase. Oh. I don't even have a weapon. I can't defend myself at all. I'm gonna shift. I'm trying to shift. Oh, damn. If that wolf is on me, I'm dead. He was stalking me, but wasn't chasing me. Alright, center rock. Center of the map. Missed the scrap metal as I was running by. Bear, wolf, oh my. I don't know how much tweaking that Cold Games has done on the timer. I know that the hunters stay longer. I don't know if he tweaked our crates though. I'm playing on normal, and I believe that the spawn timer changes based on what difficulty you're playing on. Don't quote me on that. I don't know if that's true. I just think it's true. Oh, I think that's it. I think that's it up there. And that's a wolf. That I know is a wolf. Ooh, ooh, chicken. Oh, come on, chicken, let me catch you. Yes, there's the fire. All right, I finally found the right area. The question is, I don't even care about their crate anymore. I just want to find my crate. Hunter's still over here. Oh, come on. Is there anything here? No, looks like my crate, his crate is gone. Well, I'm dead. More than likely. I'm going to pull a bloodstalker. Come here. You gonna flip me off again? Oh, that's classic. Oh, that is just so classic. Man. Oh, I hate you, Hunter. I hate you. All right, now it's, oh God, starting me up here. All right, now I'm in recovery mode. I've lost everything. The second death was just me hoping and praying my stuff was there, and I should have known better. The time had passed way too long. So now my goal is to pick up as much stuff as I can and make it to my house before, one, I freeze to death, or two, I get killed by an animal, yet again. So this is part of the game. You're going to die in this game. The fact that I went 9 days without dying is just a flipping miracle. Now, it's not really good, but the only good thing about... Oh, really? Really? A locked crate. Really? Thank you. The only good thing about dying, if there really is any good thing about dying, is the fact that my fruits and vegetables meter has raised up. I have more food in me now than before I died. So I'm not starving so much for fruits and vegetables anymore. I don't suggest that as a way to get around needing to eat and drink in this game. But I mean, if you're desperate, I guess. I was going exactly the wrong way to get home. There's a black bear to my left, but there's a crate right here. that I'm not going to be able to get to. Do not mess around with the black bears. Oh, I am not going to get home before it gets dark out, am I? This is going to get interesting. Now, the only good thing about it being dark is I might be able to see hunters and their encampment areas before I come running on them in the dark because of their fires and their blue glow sticks. But then they can see me. I don't know if that mechanic's in the game or not. I'm going to go ahead and just rest for a second. I've picked up anything. I'm going to put this bandage down here just so I have it. But you can see my fruits and vegetables are, you know, almost full up. So it's not a great way to do things, but in a pinch, I guess. All right, I'm going to try to make a beeline. And anytime I see a bar come up, I'll just shift to the side, but try to keep my mouse pointed toward home as much as possible. And hopefully don't run off any cliffs. I'm hoping I can at least see that before it happens. I will lighten the scene for you guys to make it a little bit easier to see, but I'm completely blind other than the blue glow stick, which Cold Games definitely has improved the glow stick, so it actually shines light a little bit better at a farther area, but still I'm basically blind. All right, level 3 wolf. Shift. Oh, there's home. Just as I run out of stamina. Free crate right outside the house. I'll take it. All right, guys and gals. I am Critical. This has been Subsistence. The really, really bad episode. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this content, and I'll see you in the next video. Take it easy. Bye.